Hello, IoT developers. My name is Neil. I'm a technical specialist in Microsoft IoT partner team based in China. Today, I want to show you some cool things we have built with our local partner, M5 Stack, to simplify IoT development and unlock new opportunities for device builders. Its name is Project P&P Flow. One of the biggest problems of IoT today is tighter coupling of device and solution. Implement an application that works with different kinds of devices, or develop a device that can be easily integrated by various of applications, both can be very challenging. Since there is no common language out there, proprietary protocol and customized code are required everywhere. Azure IoT Plug and Play is an ecosystem to address this issue. By using a declarative approach where devices model themselves in terms of capabilities, using an industry standard language. Device developers can now build their firmware completely independent of cloud solution. And the solution developers can implement a standard visualization reuse across different applications without any customized code. IoT Plug and Play aims to improve the interoperability in the IoT world. It is built on top of an open modeling language called DTDL, which is also used by Azure Digital Twin product to model our physical world. DTDL describes three kinds of information to model any devices in the world: what telemetry or time series data a device emits, what properties on a device that can be seen or operated by our application, and what command on a device can execute remotely. Different schema and semantic types are defined in the DTDL specification, so application can understand the exact data format and implement the most user-friendly interface for device. Azure IoT Hub and Azure IoT Central support plug-and-play out of box. Any solution built on top of them can leverage this capability to eliminate customized code and low efforts to connect plug-and-play enabled device. For the sake of time, I won't go to more details. I hope you have got a basic understanding of Azure IoT plug-and-play. This is the foundation of P&P Flow that I'm going to talk about soon. So, what is P&P Flow all about and what problems it solves? One thing I didn't talk before is the plug-and-play compatible device development. Develop a device fully conform to its model or write a modifier for existing devices is not so straightforward. Though Microsoft provides SDK and tools to accelerate this process, it still needs device developers to integrate into firmware manually. It can be error-prone or time-consumed. P&P Flow is an end-to-end solution to simplify the whole process. It is a unique IoT developer experience enable device builder to develop the schema-aware IoT devices in M5's UIFlow IDE without knowing the complexity of a plug-and-play protocol. Device capability can be further discovered by the IoT Central and work seamlessly with the template-based web UI. I should give you some background of M5 Stack. M5 Stack is an IoT partner of Microsoft. It is a startup based in Shenzhen, the Silicon Valley of China. They focus on first-party device design for quick and easy IoT development. M5 Stack has developed hundreds of modules, including sensors, actuators, and communication modules that can be easily extended and stacked to implement any kind of IoT solution. One of the key differentiators M5 Stack provides is their graphical programming IDE, UIFlow. It is very similar to make code, provide visual and drag-and-drop programming experiences, but with much more hardware supported. Actually, device development in UIFlow is already Azure IoT enabled. There is a dedicated page offer Azure IoT native operations, such as initial connection to IoT Hub or sending D2C message to IoT Hub. It lays a good foundation for Project P&P Flow. Let's get back to our main topics. I will use this page to further explain how P&P Flow actually works. Behind the scene, each M5 Stack core unit or module hardware is associated with a pre-built plug-and-play model hosted on GitHub. These models define the data schema and the semantic information that the IoT solution will see out of box. The UIFlow IDE has the built-in intelligence to know how to construct a smart block to represent telemetry, property, or command discovered from each pre-built model file. When users start to design their own device solution in UIFlow, they can pick up any smart blocks and integrate them with their own business logic. The UIFlow will dynamically compose the top-level device model based on the user-specific design and make sure it is always synchronized. To further improve the developer experiences, UIFlow natively integrated with Azure IoT Central as a companion app. So user can log in Azure IoT Central, create and update the device template and device identity without leaving UIFlow. The Azure IoT Central template-based web UI will be customized to reflect the device's exact capabilities without any manual operations. The magic happens when user click the run button to download the firmware to the device. The device will connect to Azure IoT Central and start to behave as its model expanded. The IoT Central device dashboard will map the data correctly thanks to the plug-and-play protocols behind. Okay, let's go to see some real demos. I have got a few devices for a demo. One M5 stick Core 2 IoT module as the main controller, connecting to one EMV2 unit that can be used to collect environment data, and one RGB unit to extend three color LEDs. The Core 2 is configured with the Wi-Fi credential to be able to connect to public internet. Here, I have also created a fresh Azure IoT Central application for the demo purpose. As you can see, there is no device or template existing in my application at this moment. Then I will go to UIFlow to show you how these things work together. Now I'm in the UIFlow IDE. My Core 2 is already remembered by my browser and remotely connected to my session over a secure token. The first thing I will do is to add the unit to my workspace. Click this button, we can see all the units supported by the UIFlow. For those units that have the Azure IoT plug and play support, you can see there is a small icon associated with it. You can also filter these devices by using the checkbox button here. I will add EMV2 and RGB unit to my design. They connect through the port A and port B of the Core 2 IoT module. Then I will go to the place where we can use the plug and play blocks. Go to the IoT Cloud, Azure, and IoT plug and play. Drag and drop the connector to IoT Central block to my cameras. On the right side, we will see a new plug and play icon will be displayed. Click this to expand the P&P Flow control panel. There are three tabs here. I will use the first one, IoT Central control panel, to set up a connection to my application. User should enter their Azure IoT Central application URL prefix. For the application I just created, it is P&P Flow. Then I need to provide the API token to be able to authenticate with my application. I can just click this small icon to go to the API token generation page to create a new one. For the demo purpose, I will use the existing token. Actually, this step is to verify the API token and save it to the web page to make REST API call later. After successful login, more settings and operation will be prompted. The scope ID is the identifier of our application, and it will be automatically filled into the IoT Central connection block here. The model ID is the ID generated random ID. You can modify it or use it your own model ID, or leave it unchanged to be able to get started. Now I will start to design my device in UIFlow. I want my device to collect temperature, humidity, and accelerometer data to the cloud every 30 seconds. I will show you how easy I can do this by using P&P Flow. Go to the IoT P&P page, drag and drop the same telemetry block to the workspace. From the drop-down list, select the UMV2. You can see all the telemetries that UMV2 support. Since we don't need the pressure data, we can just delete it. I can do the same for the accelerometer data, but I want to show you a different way to do it. From the hardware category, you can see all the hardware operations that are built in support by the IoT module. Select the IMU, and there is a P&P ready block here. Drag and drop to our workspace. You can see IMU is pre-selected. For the same reason, we don't need a gyro, so just remove them. As usual, we need some control block and some timer to control the device behavior. I will add a 30-second timer at the end of the loop to control the telemetry. I also want to send some properties to cloud. So we can go to the IoT P&P page, select the update property to the cloud. From the drop-down list, I can select the device information interface. There are several properties that you can use to report. I will keep only the manufacturer and firmware version, for example. The last thing I want to do with my device is to control the external RGB unit. We can use the P&P ready block to do this. Let's go to the unit RGB and select the ready block. It already implemented the set color and set brightness method. The parameters are defined by the pre-built P&P model, so don't worry about it. The UIFlow know how to pass them to the hardware operations. I will copy this block and select the set brightness, so we keep both method. Okay, that's all I want to deal with my device. Now, I want to show you the model that I create. We can go to the model view. We can see the exact model that is created by the UIFlow. When we adjust our design in this workspace, the model will be changed on the fly to reflect the actual behavior of the device. The next step is to connect my device to the solution. Normally, the solution needs to be configured specifically for this device, but for P&P Flow, this is not necessary. Let's go back to the IoT Central control panel. We can create a template. Just name my template. And we can also create a device identity associated with this template. As you can see, the device ID and the device identity, which is the device key, is automatically filled in this IoT Central connection block. So everything is ready. Next step, I will download the firmware, download the script to the device. Just click the run button. And then I can use this small icon to go to the device page in the IoT Central application. Here you can see there are a few tabs configured by this template. There is a default about page displaying the properties that we just sent to cloud. And there is an overview page display the exact telemetry we want to send to cloud, temperature, humidity, and the accelerometer data. And also there is a command page that we can use to control the device LED. For example, if I want to set the first LED to red, I can do this. all these things we just played in IoT Central is automatically adapted for our device because the template is created based on the model that we compose in the UIFlow. I didn't do any manual configuration. Well, this is all I want to show you today. P&P Flow is now in public preview. We're still working on it, so more hardware will be supported, and the customized plug and play model block will be supported later. Feel free to have a try and give us some feedback. Thanks for watching.